How do I explain this game? I'm surprised that I'm even playing it. What is Kimono Cats about? Well, I struggle to describe the purpose of this game. Apparently, they're two young cats on a date in a Japanese-themed street festival. There's no doubt that this game is cute. The music is nice too. I like video games, and I like cats. So shouldn't I like Kimono Cats? Well, at first I was quite confused. What's with all these bubble things? That's the objective. You chuck darts at those targets, while hoping to impress your date. This cat is building a village, and she's a big part of that plan. Easy there, guy. Don't get ahead of yourself. You're just dating. The point is that he has to impress her to win her love. You'd think she's a gold digger, being enamored by so many gifts. But she seems to reward him with items for his village. It's not much of a story, but I respect it. Fall in love, build a family, a village, help those around you. That's nice, wholesome content that I like to see on Apple Arcade. Isn't that right, Boots? Francisca and Boots are cat lovers, so maybe they'd like to play this game. Nah, they don't seem interested. It's only a one-player game anyway. And that's probably the hardest part of this review. It was tough to stop playing the game. But what's the objective? It took me a while to figure that out. But basically, the main objective appears to be collecting coins. That's how you can progress to the next level. So in addition to keeping your date happy, it's about money. I should have known. There's a Polish saying that sums this up perfectly. When the reason is unknown, the reason is money. So, where's the challenge? Can't you just throw the darts at the coin bubbles? You can! See, Kimono Cats is loaded with mini-games. But if your aim is true, you don't have to play them. You could just aim for darts, coins, and shots to keep the kitty happy. At least that's how I like to play the game. I wait for shots that I want to take. That's the challenge. You can run out of darts. I was playing for quite a while before I even knew that was an issue. But when I ran out, I hit my first glitch. You basically have an infinite amount of darts, but they're buried in the ground at your village. If your main supply runs out, you have to use the metal detector to dig them out of the ground. It's a little tedious, but not too bad. Unfortunately, that's where the game jammed. Minor glitch. Restart. Once I knew about needing ammo and how to get it, this wasn't much of a problem. Also, once I knew about the different targets, it was a lot easier to progress in the game. Mainly I was targeting things to keep the girl kitty happy. But then I was aiming for more advanced targets. Here's the most useful combo that I found. First, turn the scene to night. There's a guy in a blue bubble. I'm not that familiar with Japanese folklore, but that's what toggles the day-night mode. Once it's dark, look for the fireworks bubble. That starts the fireworks display. This multiplies the number of darts and coins awarded from bubbles. It's a really quick way to get through the levels. But of course, are you really playing Kimono Cats if you're avoiding the mini-games? There are ones I like more than others. A perfect example is the throwing star. I can practice my ninja training. The Hidden Leaf Village would be proud. There's also a food on a stick challenge. It's a little fun. Kinda reminds me of Kaboom on Atari. Essentially, a lot of these mini-games are like retro games. Does this bouncing potato remind you of anything? The point is if the girl cat starts to get bored or sad, you can cheer her up by targeting the bubbles with her needs. If you make a match, you can win her affection points, such as giving the cat a pet cat. So cute. Be careful though, if you pick the wrong thing, she could get upset or sick. Like if you give her bad food, she throws up. Now I'm thinking if you're on a first date, and the girl just pukes on the street, romance is probably over, and she might not speak to you ever again. Fortunately, these are cats, and they're always looking for new places to throw up. In other words, this girl cat is very forgiving. In general, the game is pretty chill. It's somewhat challenging, but not too difficult. This is more like digital eyewash. Give your brain a good scrub. Clean out those negative thoughts. Instead, just hang out in this friendly festival. But again, there were minor issues. On level 7, the background started glitching out. It didn't stop me from getting to level 8, though. But after restarting, I lost my cute peck hat. So sad. And also, it seems that including Game Center achievements is a requirement for Apple Arcade games. But only having one achievement is kinda lazy. Greg Johnson is a legendary game developer. Have you ever played Toe Jam and Earl? This is why I'm surprised that the low-hanging fruit was missed. There are a lot of really simple ideas. Start a fireworks display, find a soda can in your village, give flowers. A future update could easily fix that. Meanwhile, I didn't try the multiplayer features, and it was nice that this game could be played offline, but I'll probably test out online features later. Probably the hardest thing to do in this game was to stop playing. So, before I get back to playing the game, I figured I'd give you some more tips on how to play the game. The first is beating up Mickey Mouse. If you see a bubble that looks like that famous Disney mouse, chuck a dart at its head. That starts battle mode. When that starts, aim for the one good bubble, not the two bad bubbles. These battles are usually easy to win, so if you're going to start a fight, win the fight. But they're not always fights. Sometimes it's just about being nice to the other characters, like making this little kitten happy. Or giving this panda lady a sugary treat. That's what I enjoy about this game. It rewards being nice. Isn't that wonderful? Anyway, if you have questions about the game, you can leave a comment. Thanks for watching.